climate change, the decarbonisation of the economy and sustainability are at the centre of citizens' concerns today. The Naturgy Foundation and the Club of Rome, aware of and involved in this concern, have collaborated for a long time to promote a rigorous reflection and debate on these issues, which will also enable society as a whole to have a greater knowledge and understanding of the challenge we face.
Europa se ha planteado unos objetivos muy ambiciosos en materia de reducción de gases de efecto invernadero 2050 y también unos compromisos muy exigentes en periodos intermedios, 2030, por ejemplo. Todas las medidas tienen que ser evaluadas, analizadas, consideradas y todas con muchísimo detenimiento porque pueden tener impacto tanto en los consumidores, en las empresas.
Y en este sentido el carbon pricing es un elemento muy importante porque va a obligar a controlar las emisiones y va a penalizar a aquellos factores que emitan más gases de los que realmente nos vamos a poder permitir para llegar al 2050.
The European Commission intends to have all the legislation necessary to meet the commitments made by 2030 revised by June 2021. This specifically includes the directives on the emissions market, renewable energies and energy efficiency.
Es un momento muy complejo que va a exigir una transición energética difícil y que al mismo tiempo se produce en una situación donde la propia economía se va a ir digitalizando y va a ir cambiando de una manera espectacular en los próximos años.
Y el Club de Roma y la Fundación Naturgy no son para nada ajenas a esta situación, al contrario, han trabajado desde hace varios años y de manera proactiva, buscando espacios donde se propicien debates, donde se hagan análisis rigurosos y donde consigamos o se pueda conseguir una sociedad cada vez más y mejor informada, porque indudablemente todos estos cambios nos afectarán a todos.
Both institutions, following the usual practice of relying on experts on each subject of analysis and research, present a paper on carbon pricing prepared by Compass Lexicon, one of the most recognized and experienced economic consulting firms in the energy sector. According to economic theory, carbon pricing is based on the polluter pays principle. Under different modalities, it aims to force the agents that generate greenhouse gases to internalize the negative externalities of pollution.
So there are fundamentally two ways to put a price on carbon. So you either have a carbon tax, which is setting a rate that the producer has to pay, or you have carbon markets.
When it comes to a cap and trade scheme, so a carbon market, the beauty of it, if you want, is that you can set the cap, meaning the total amount of allowances, and then let the market play to determine the price of carbon that will result from the trading of market participants.
And this cap annually decreases, giving an incentive for companies to decrease their pollution each year.
The application of one or the other alternative, or even a combination of both, has varied between countries. In 2005, the European Union created the largest emissions market in the world, the Emissions Trading Scheme, or ETS. This mechanism operates in 31 countries and covers 45% of the Union's greenhouse gas emissions. The effectiveness of the ETS is based on the price of greenhouse gas emissions, which should be an incentive to decarbonisation. But since the launch of the market, the various crises and an oversupply of emission rights have resulted in a price that is too volatile and low, always below the social cost of carbon. So far, the European Union has tried to alleviate this situation with several price stabilization mechanisms, with which it adjusts the allowed emissions according to market developments. On the other hand, in order to align with the goals of the Green Deal, the emissions market system will have to be adapted,
One needs to distinguish, on the one hand side, reforms which would have to deal with the current framework. So for instance, the linear reduction factor, which is setting the yearly decrease of the cap, could be adjusted, could be strengthened, or the cap could be rebased to reflect better the existing emissions. On the other hand, there could be structural reforms of the ETS. These include, for instance, the possibility to modify the market stabilization mechanisms, the MSR, or even to implement mechanisms such as a carbon price floor, which would provide greater visibility to investors into the long-term trajectory for the price of carbon.
The ETS presents other challenges. First, its real impact on reducing emissions in Europe is difficult to quantify, as it is overlapped with other initiatives, such as the promotion of renewable generation or energy efficiency. In addition, European companies could lose competitiveness against those in other areas with fewer environmental restrictions.
And therefore, this will lead to an actual increase in the total emissions in the world. So that's what we mean by the carbon leakage concept.
The European Commission has already implemented a framework to deal with carbon leakage or potential carbon leakage, with compensation of both the direct cost and the indirect costs.
The European Union will have to decide whether to maintain carbon pricing mechanisms as a pillar of its climate policy, which would require a thorough reform of the ETS and complementary national mechanisms, together with the development of policies to mitigate the impact on the most affected European industries, regions, and customers.